Problems and challenges faced by the people who returned from the LRA captivity have been told in various media. But today, we have learned that the local council leadership is also acting as a barrier to the programs set by government to support these people.
The most affected leaders are the LOC ones and councillors, who it is alleged that sometimes register these people without their knowledge.
One time, they come to us. They say that you have to first form a group of which they are going to give you something to do. Maybe they will take you to school, or they give you what? Something which will support you. But after, when you have even formed a group, you find that nothing is coming. And that thing can make you to lose what? Hope.
The peace is there, but the human need is still more insufficient for us in the community due to stigmatizations and other things that you should reach us by our names. We don't have a channels of our communications. So we need someone actually to present us.
28-year-old Rubankine Jimmy, who was born when his mother was in LRA captivity, says segregation and discrimination has become rampant as the leaders see them as outsiders. This makes it difficult for them to access basic services in public places like hospitals.
I lost my father during those times, and now I'm only with my mom, so she struggled with me up to now. There was no one to take care of me. If the government can help to improve our knowledge, I request them, at least for those who want to go back to school, at least to give us that opportunity.
Greed and corruption are seen as the driving factors that are making these leaders to take advantage of the former LRA combatants.
Ay karma tier karor ne bo lc mi penyone ni lc ni igamo ana gunyi diang ma mega biruti ni gamo.
According to the United Nations, between 60,000 to 100,000 children were abducted by the Lord's Resistance Army in northern Uganda and beyond. 29-year-old Ato Pamela says after they returned from captivity, some leaders have taken advantage of their situation. Sometimes they are registered in groups, but the government intervention that was promised never reaches them. However, the LOC One chairperson of Kasubi Ward in Badege, Laiwi Division of Gulu City, believes that his counterparts could be acting as a result of poor communication.
Some of these people who are complaining because of the service delivery, they are from Amur district. But we here in the city, there's nothing like poor service delivery.
Susan Blanche Alal, who has extensively conducted research on the livelihood of the people who returned from the LRA captivity, emphasized that the government needs to keep a direct communication with these people.
Not included in any programming or in developing any policy or their involvement in the project programming. So that makes them always not considered, and they are not always benefiting from what comes.
And most of them are not allocated land within their families. The civil society and other state actors are also being encouraged to improve on their service delivery. The Gulu Women League chairperson Betty Atim condemns the act of these leaders. She is calling on the government to become critical and concentrate their energies on the economic recovery of all the people who were abducted by the LRA rebels.
They said you're abducted when you're 6, you come back when you're 20, you're abducted when you're 8, you come back when you have 2 children. This is very unfortunate. I'm even appealing to the government of Uganda to see how we can come up to help these people, because there are many in number.
The Gulu Women League chairperson met some of the affected people while presiding over a symposium organized by a group of researchers in Gulu City.
The process for the thousands of people here in Acholi sub-region who returned from LRA captivity has been deemed as slow. The leadership is being called on to stop acting as a barrier. Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Gulu City.